Hello, today we shall see the Bayle opening zone. In the last lecture, we had seen the various Bloom zones that the Bloom machines were divided into, and the six zones that we had seen were the machines for bale opening, machines for coarse cleaning, machines for blending, machines for intermediate cleaning, machines for fine cleaning, and machines for card feeding. Out of these six zones, today we shall be looking at the first zone. So, zone one, in which we shall be looking at machines for bale opening. We know that the cotton enters the mill in the form of a bale, and the first object of the blue room must be to open out the bale. And let us take a look at the machines that are both conventional as well as modern. Used for bale opening. So, features of an effective bale opener. The first feature should be that it should be able to open the pressed cotton into tufts that are as small and as even as possible. It should allow the presentation of a large bale layout. An effective bale opener must be flexible to operate with blends. And along with blending at the start of the process. So the blending operation must start as soon as possible, and if it is possible, it should be beginning at the bale opener level. It must be able to extract material evenly and also at the same time gently from all the bales of the layout. It should also be easy to program. So with this background, let us first take a look at the conventional bale openers that we had. The two openers were hopper bale breaker and hopper feeder. So the images of the hopper bale breaker, material from the bales is placed manually on the feed lattice and is pushed towards the inclined spike lattice. In the earlier lecture, we have seen the inclined spike lattice in detail, and material now in this case is being fed on the feed lattice, which will take the material which is shown here. This is the feed lattice. Here the material, this is known as a hopper, where the material is manually placed and which is pushed towards this inclined spike lattice. The inclined spike lattice, because of its spikes, will pick up material and take it upwards. So this is your feed lattice. The inclined spike lattice carries the fiber lump upwards due to its rotation. You can see the direction, the arrows it is showing. This is the way it rotates. So the material is taken upwards. So that's the inclined spike lattice. So these clumps pass between the inclined spike lattice and the oppositely rotating evener roller. So this is the evener roller. Actually speaking, the evener roller should have taken the material and taken it outside. But in this case, one thing to observe is that the evener roller is rotating in the opposite direction to that of the actual delivery that it should have had. And this has got a purpose. It is done because the evener lattice can replace the evener roller in this case here. But this opposite rotation is given to this particular evener roller. So that whenever the material reaches the top of the inclined spike lattice, if the material is not small enough, is not broken or opened out into small tufts, it is not being allowed to pass in between this space between evener roller and inclined spike lattice. So the material is thrown again and again back into the hopper, so that every time it will come up the inclined spike lattice. And only when it is small enough to pass through the space between these two elements, only then it will be allowed to go further. So this evener roller acts like a control over here for the size of tufts. So what is being said here is only if the fiber clumps are sufficiently opened and small enough to pass through the space between the inclined spike lattice and the evener roller, the tufts go ahead and are stripped off the inclined spike lattice by the leather flap beater. So there is one more leather flap beater over here. If the material is able to come through this particular space, only then it will then be taken up by the leather flap beater, which is also there so that the inclined spike lattice is cleaned and the material passes further. So we should pay attention to the direction of rotation of all these rollers and the lattices. If they are not small enough, they are thrown back into the hopper till they are sufficiently open. So the production rates and the degree of opening are determined by the speed of the inclined spike lattice and its spacing between the inner roller. So if the spacing between the inner roller is more, larger clumps of fibers are allowed to go out, and in that way the production rates will increase, and but the degree of opening will not be that good. So the spacing between the inner roller and the inclined spike lattice here will decide the production rate and the degree of opening that is being achieved. So with this, let us look at the conventional hopper feeder. So what we see here is the image of an hopper feeder. Material from the hopper bale breaker is passed on to the hopper feeder feed lattice via the transport duct. So there are the material is transport using a transport duct, and material comes into the hopper of this hopper feeder. Again, if one sees, this is the feed lattice. The inclined spike lattice carries the fiber lumps upwards due to its rotation. In a similar manner, just like hopper bale breaker, the lattice will pick the material and take it upwards. These lumps pass between the inclined spike lattice and the oppositely rotating Ebner roller or Ebner lattice. In this case, Ebner lattice is being shown. In the earlier case, Ebner roller was there. It has got the same function of not allowing large clumps of fibers to go or pass through. So it is rotating in the opposite direction, and again, just like before, the larger clumps are thrown back into the hopper till they become small enough to pass through. So only if the fiber clumps are sufficiently open further, the tufts go ahead and are stripped off by the of the inclined spike lattice by the leather flap beater. So whatever material gets stuck onto this inclined spike lattice is taken away by the leather flap beater further for processing. Else they are thrown back into the hopper till they are sufficiently open. So the difference between the hopper bale breaker and the hopper feeder is that the angle of the inclined spike lattice with the feed lattice is different. So here the angle, as you can see, it is acute with the feed lattice, and in the bale breaker it was obtuse. In case of the hopper feeder, it is more difficult for large clumps of fibers to climb up the inclined spike lattice. So here, in this case, it becomes more difficult because it is inclined in this manner. The fibers tend to fall more often into the hopper before they are allowed to pass through. So that means the difficulty level for the fiber clumps to pass and go further has increased from hopper bale breaker to hopper feeder. So it has to compulsorily reduce the size, and only then they are allowed to pass through this hopper feeder. In case of the hopper feeder, it is more difficult for large clumps of fibers to climb up the inclined spike lattice and therefore fall back many times before they are light enough to reach the Ebner roller of the Ebner lattice. So general observation about the hopper bale breaker and hopper feeder is that the intensity of opening is dependent on the distance between the inclined spike lattice and the Ebner roller, the speed ratios between the two, the total working surface, and the number of points that are there on the inclined spike lattice. Since the fiber tufts are thrown back into the hopper again and again, the rotation of the material results in a thorough mixing, but there are chances of formation of nips, and this increases with the increase in the quantity of material in the hopper. So what are nips? Basically, nips are small entanglements of fibers about the size of a needle head that consists of only fibers, or both fibers and some foreign particle like seed or leaf fragment. So this particular feature where the material is thrown back again and again into the hopper is good from the point of view of blending, but from the point of view of nip generation, it creates more nips when such action is taking place in the hopper. More rotation means more formation of nips, which is undesirable. So now let us take a look at the most modern bale opening machines that are available. The earlier hopper bale breaker and hopper feeder were conventional. So let us take a look at how things have changed today. The machines in the modern bale opener, they travel past the stationary bales that are laid out, and extract material from the top of the bale to the bottom. So traveling machines have the advantage of being able to process more bales at a time as a unit, which is also known as charge, resulting in a better long-term blending. A bale layout may be of 130 bales from 4 to 6 different sources, which was not possible in the earlier conventional machine. Spaces are left between the bales so that the extraction roller is able to adjust itself to the varying heights of bales. The machine, being completely electronically controlled, can extract material evenly in spite of varying heights and bale densities. So the machine is capable of extracting material as evenly as possible, even if the bales are varying in heights and bale densities. So with this, let us see what are the automatic bale openers that are available to us from two leading companies. One is Tutzler, which is called as Blendomat BOA, and it's from Germany. Whereas we also have another machine that is from Ritter, A11 Uniflock, which is a company of from Switzerland. So with this, let us take a look at the video of this particular machine by Tutzler. So with this, we have seen one main difference between the earlier conventional hopper bale breaker and hopper feeder, where one had to feed manually the pieces of the bale into the hopper, and then only the machine would take over from there. But as we have seen in the modern automatic bale openers, we get much smaller tuft size in the first stage, and it is automatically taken by the traveling machine, whereas the bale is stationary, and from the top of the surface of the bale itself, a small tufts are picked up by the machine. So similarly, let us take a look at the machine by Ritter, which is known as Uniflock A12. Thank you. So one thing to observe here after looking at both the videos is that the modern bail openers open up the material to a smaller tuft size, which is very important from the point of view of opening. We had seen in our earlier lecture of concept of opening, where cleaning, for better cleaning, opening to or creating new surfaces is very important. So in this case, we can see when we compare it with the conventional machines, the modern machines are able to open the tufts to a much smaller size in the first stage of opening, and that too at the bail opening level. And so we shall see later that a lot of machines in the sequence can just be eliminated, and we can save the fibers from any kind of damage, much damage rather. And therefore, the automatic bail openers are very important from that point of view. The working is very important from that point of view, because it is able to bring down the size of the tufts at the very beginning. So with this, let us see how these machines, the details of these machines. So Trutzler Blendomat BDT020 is the model name. And we can see this particular traveling machine that is going over the on the surface of the bales. And we can see here that there is an inclined profile of the bales that are laid down. It is done on purpose so that one gets a long-term kind of blending. And when it is picking up tufts at one in one layer or at one in one traverse, it is able to take tufts from all the areas of the bales, that is from the top, and a few bales from the somewhere in the middle, and a few bales somewhere at the bottom, since we have created an inclined profile over here. So bales are extracted continuously in the inclined position. Therefore, as soon as a bale is exhausted, it shall be replaced by a new one at the other end. So also one can maintain a sort of continuity in feeding of bales. So as soon as the bales on the left hand side gets exhausted, on the right hand side a new bale is added, so that the process remains continuous. So this is how the bales on one side, as it is getting exhausted because of the incline, a new bale is added on the other side. So now let us take a look at the special features of say Ritter A11 Uniflock, and some details as to how these machines really work, the internal details. So this is the image, and this is the bale, and these are the parts which shall be explained one by one. One here is the feed duct, which is secured to the floor. Chassis with turret, it moves to and fro on the guide rails. So two here, this is the chassis along with the turret, this particular part which is placing itself on the bale, and this is able to move to and fro on the surface of the bale, picking up tufts as it traverses, and then it is sucked out and taken, and it goes via this feed duct and it is taken to the next machine. So extracting assembly, which is three over here, it is supported by the turret and can be raised up and down. We have seen in the video how this turret is able to move to and fro, as well as it can move up and down. It has replaceable double teeth rollers. We have also seen the ruler in our earlier lecture. The profile of the blades that it has, which can change the direction on and when the chassis reverses as it is moving to and fro. So because of the way the double teeth is there on that on the roller, the material can be extracted during both the directions of the travel. So this is how we had seen this profile in the earlier lecture. So this is the image of the roller which is there inside this particular turret, which moves to and fro. So the turret is able to swivel 180 degrees. We have seen this in the video also. This is able to turn like this 180 degrees, and the bales can be laid to the left as well as the right of the machine, and it can work on both the sides. New bales can be prepared on one side and left to acclimatize or condition while the other bales are being processed on the other side. So if this bale layout is being processed on the other side, maybe to the right, the bales could be just left to get conditioned, and in the meanwhile, once this processing is over, the turret will just rotate or swivel by 180 degrees, and this bale layout could then be taken for processing, while on the other side we can again lay out bales for the next batch for conditioning. So this is how this process can be made continuous. So what are the special features of Uniflock or Blendomat? Uniflock enables 130 bales in a typical layout comprising of 4 to 6 different sources in a length of say 47.2 meters with a production of 2000 to 2400 kgs per hour, and it has also got a capacity to process up to 4 blends. So it is quite versatile in terms of processing of blends, and we can see the production levels that are there. And also, it's amazing that it can these machines can process 130 bales at a time, along with 4 to 6 different sources of fibers. So Blendomat has got a special feature. It gives a very good long-term blending, as we have seen, because of the incline. It is able to pick out material from any level of the bale or any height of the bale. It is because of the incline, simultaneously it is picking up fibers from the top as well as the middle, and also from the bottom of the bale. And since the characteristics of the fiber may differ along the as the height of the bale changes, this particular incline will help in taking fibers of different characteristics from different areas of the bale, and therefore one can achieve a good long-term blending. And it is not then therefore done charge by charge. So while deciding on any bale opener, one must always consider the capacity for the number of bales in the feed. That means we should always look at how many bales it can process at one time. So with this short introduction to the bale opening machines, that is the automatic bale opener, as well as a slight insight into the conventional bale opening machines, let us see what is next in line in the blue room sequence. What is next? So the automatic bale opener creates a large quantity of surfaces that have not been cleaned yet. So this particular bale openers, the modern as well as conventional, they have created some new surfaces, and they are not cleaned. So our next process should focus on cleaning them as soon as possible immediately, so that they are not again, the trash is again not mixed up with the fibers, and so the next process should always be cleaning. Therefore, after this kind of opening, a cleaning machine is required. Large surfaces are already exposed. There is no need for any more intensive opening. Therefore, in the next zone, machines shall be fed in free flight. We have seen in our earlier lecture that free flight gives us a quite a gentle kind of opening and cleaning as well. So we do not need any more intensive opening, because in this particular zone we have already achieved a good amount of opening and created new surfaces. So the next machine can have a gentle kind of treatment to the fibers by feeding them in free flight, and therefore be treated very, very gently without any kind of feeding requirement of any kind of feeding device. So with this, we come to the end of this lecture. Thank you.